Welcome back to the channel, RPA Champions. Automation is truly amazing. In today's video, in just 2-3 steps, we're gonna create an automation that is gonna allow you to save countless hours of time if it's something that you do. Let's say that you wanted to follow all of the people from this account and then from a different account and then from a different account and so on. So you wanted to follow their account and now you want to follow all of the people on this account. How would you do something like that? We can do this with Microsoft Power Automate Desktop in just a few minutes and in just a few actions without any coding. And just like this really cool process that we're gonna do right now, we can, if we learn how to use Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, we can automate pretty much anything that comes to mind. And if we throw in AI into it, we can do so much more. Creating automated content, reaching out, emails, pretty much anything. Soon automation is going to replace people that work in front of the computer, but we are not there yet. Let's jump into Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and see how to build this amazing automation. So the first action that is going to be, it is going to be to open a Microsoft Windows and go to this page right here of Singapore Airline. We're gonna follow all of the people that follow Singapore Airline. Let's add Microsoft Edge and let's also open this to attach to a running instance. This is going to make it easier to test out and to configure. So we're opening this page right here. It is going to take us directly to here. And then we want to click on these buttons right there. To click on those buttons right there, we're going to add an action that is going to be to click on a button. Let's see if we can click on a web page, click on a link on a web page. So this action right here. We are going to add a UI element to this action right here. And we're going to add this follow div, unfortunately. It has created an action. Let's save it. Go to our actions right here. I have already created some actions previously just to try this process and to see how easy it is going to be. Now, the selector that was created for us automatically looks something like this. Now, what you have to do is you have to remove all of these divs. Why? Because if the page changes and if there is any other div elements on the page, this selector is not going to work. Therefore, what we need to do is to uncheck all of these boxes that we have selected right here. And one of the main reasons why selectors fail is that we are unable to create good selectors or selectors that stick. It is extremely easy also with all of the tools that Microsoft Power Automate Desktop has made available to make selectors that are very reliable and that don't fail and that can be repeated and repeated in the automation without the automation failing. Now, we have this selector right here. However, we are going to add an ordinal because I have already seen in this selector and there is no class or any other value that I can use that could relate to this selector right here after I have removed all of the different structure from it. So let's add the ordinal and let's test this selector right here and see what happens. We're going to select our page of Instagram and see that it is selecting this button right here. If we go back to that page, we can see that there is a follow button right here and then there is all follow buttons down here. So if I change this maybe to 1, let's say, and let's click on test, that should give me the first follow button here. Now, if I change it to 2, I think you get the idea. If we change it to 2, it is going to be the next button. And just like that, we have created an automation that is going to follow on all of those people. Now, let's just save this for the time being. And last thing that we need to do is we have to repeat this action how many times? This has 22 followers, so we have to repeat this 22 times. Let's create a loop that is going to repeat this action 22 times. We're going to start at 1, increment or go to 20 or 19, and increment by 1. Click on save, move our action in here, and I think that's pretty much everything that we have to do. Let me see on this page if there's anything missing. Now, I was thinking that maybe we had to load in view all of the different follow buttons, but I think that as we are clicking on the next follow button, the other buttons might be loaded in view as we are scrolling down. However, I'm not 100% sure if that is the case. We're going to see in this example right here. So we're gonna follow all of the different followers of this profile, and then we're going to try this with a profile that has a few more followers. And just to remind you how easy this is, this seems to be working just fine. So let's stop this automation and let's try it maybe on a profile that has a few more followers like this. So all I have to do is change this link right here inside of our automation. Inside of the link, all I have to do is change it like this to this, and we are going to copy this, and now we're not gonna attach to a running instance, we're just gonna run a new browser or a new page. All right, let's see if this is going to work and if it's going to follow all of the different pages of this profile. Now also remember that just like we have created this automation to follow all of these people, we can also create a automation that is going to, all right, we have a little issue. So once we visit this page, we have to click on this button. Now to avoid doing that, I'm going to change this back to attach to run new instance and visit it by URL so that we can just test. While we are testing our automation, there is no need to see or do different steps that are going to take time or consume time while we're just testing our automation. So let's run it one more time. Let's see if it's going to attach to the right page, and let's see if it's going to click on all of the different buttons without needing for us to scroll down or do anything else. This profile has 752 followers, so if I were to include or write inside of my loop 752, it should theoretically scroll down all the way to the bottom. So it has finished following all of these people. And what we can also do is we can scroll with our mouse and load all of these people ourselves, or we can also create an automation that is going to load. But if I want to do something just really, really quickly, I would just scroll like this and load everything in view without having the need to do anything, and then just scrape whatever I want to scrape. So let's say we want to start from 20 and we want to add at 40, increment by 1. Let's scrape all of those profiles from 20 to 40. And just like I'm doing this, I could pretty much do any kind of action or step that I wanted. I could scrape their name, I could create a custom message for them. For right now, I'm just following them and doing it in two actions. This is how easy Microsoft Power Automate Desktop is. This process shows how Microsoft Power Automate Desktop or automation technologies can truly improve your performance during your work and during the activities that you do in front of your computer. Now, if you have stayed with me for so long, I imagine that you like this kind of. If you like this kind of content, please remember to subscribe to the channel. It means a lot to me. Also, without you, this channel would not exist. Therefore, thank you so much for watching my videos, and I will see you in the next video.